Hey guys, Chung here. So today we are in the MTR and we are going to Sham Shui Po. I'm going to actually show you guys a location that I'm going to scout today because there have been people asking me like to show Hong Kong on its own because like I am now there and they are interested if there are any special locations that most tourists don't know about. So today we're going to Sham Shui Po and we're going to Garden Hill. I am now at Sham Shui Po station, so I am here. So if we go to D2, we go to actually the Golden Shopping Mall, and if you go to C1 or C2, you actually go to Sham Shui Po or Avenue Street, which is actually pretty well known for a lot of people that you can buy stuff there, electronics, and also quite a lot of camera accessories. At the Golden Shopping Mall, you can actually get like a lot of camera accessories and also upgrade like your PC with affordable parts. But today we are going to D2 and we are actually going to show you a route to a special place. So we've made it to the top and yeah, you can see here behind me there is a square area. We can basically fly a drone from here. This is not a no-fly zone, however do note we're quite high, so you can see that top of the building there quite close by, so you don't want to fly above that building or higher than that building. So we're basically like limited to I think 50-60 meters. I don't would go by the 90 meter rule because like in Hong Kong we have basically a 90 meter height, but because we're actually on top of a hill which is quite high, we don't want to go too high because this location here is close to like several big mountains, like Taimosan and like a few other mountains here. But because it's summer here, there's also helicopters flying around checking for forest fires or hill fires, so I kind of want to look out for those helicopters that are passing by. But also we're at a kind of flight route of some planes that are landing in Hong Kong. So basically the planes that actually fly by here pretty much next to the Taimosan route and goes to above Tsing Yi and basically lands at the airport. So kind of want to look out for that and not fly too high because we're already at such a height. So we're actually going to fly a drone here and see how the shot looks like and what we can actually film here. I have to say like the shots that I've done actually looks quite nice. From here I can say you have enough space to do a parallax movement. You can actually see on your map on the on your phone basically how far you can fly from left to right, and you actually get enough space to do a nice parallax movement. However, flying in and out is not that great, and up and down you also don't have that much space. So mainly you can get a nice cityscape here and also a nice view of the mountain. So this is a really nice location. However, one thing you do notice, there's quite a lot of trees here, so you do need to look out when you are flying off or landing. Another thing is it is also quite windy here on top because we're on such a high level. It's actually quite windy for the spark, but it was able to get like still nice steady shots. One thing, we are now going one level below because on top of here there's too many trees to actually get like a nice landscape shot with your camera. We're going to a level below here where you can get a good landscape shot even with your phone. Okay, so we've gone down one level from top of there to this level, and you can see now there's no trees blocking, and we can see the buildings behind me, and we can get that nice landscape shot. Right now it is too clear of a sky, so doing time lapses today won't see much moving actually. Maybe later at night, but yeah, today is only windy up here. It's too sunny to do much less or to do a time lapse. We can at least get some really nice clean landscape shots. There's not too much smog or fog or mist going on, so we can get like a pretty nice shot of the cityscape. Yeah, sorry for the difficult lighting here, because there's just a branch in front of the sun and I can't really get to another spot, but we're actually one level lower than before, so there's like multiple levels, and by using the stairs we can just go down here. And this is an interesting spot, especially if you want to do time lapse. Here we have like a road or a street here, this street. It goes all the way to Nam Chung. And basically you can get like a really nice time-lapse shot here, zooming all the way in. Too bad I didn't bring any tele lens with me today, so I can't really get that shot, but I can get you like a visual. But yeah, pretty much you can go here also by night and get like nighttime time lapses. Only thing is there is no street lighting here, so do note that you need to bring a flashlight here to get up here and also get back down. But the main thing is like this is a really interesting place. It's not busy, there's not many people who know about this location, and yeah, you can get absolutely fantastic shots of Hong Kong, the city view, the cityscape, and yeah, you can get all the nice tall high rises here in shot, and also get like several great yeah, places to get like time lapses. So that was mainly it from Garden Hill. Hopefully you guys like this video, and please give me a thumbs up. If you are new to this channel, please hit the subscribe button here below. Also, if you have any suggestions where in Hong Kong I should scout, or like which city you want me to find another interesting spot, please comment here below and I'll check it out, and I'll see you guys the next time. Bye bye.